They don't wanna see me doing good now. They just wanna keep me in the hood now.
If they wanna fight, I'ma fight back. Why they wanna do a nigga like that?
The whole game is about concrete, right? But what makes it bigger is this brother, I don't know him from a can of paint. But we walked the same journey, came up in the same ghetto, just a different name. I don't give a fuck if you come from, you from North Philly, you from Harlem, you from Brooklyn, you from Bankhead, all that shit the same. There's a ghetto, everybody's struggling, everybody trying to figure it out. But he saw one of my posts, because I was speaking to him without speaking to him. It was a connection, it's this crazy unorthodox connection that we have coming up in the struggle penitentiary and all that shit, right? So he seen me, I'm just telling dudes pull the trigger. The only reason I'm telling dudes pull the trigger because the lifestyle we come from, we pull the trigger without thinking. We don't give a fuck. We're just, boom, we're slamming the nigga. So my whole thing is like, in a way, without saying it, had the same mentality, pull the trigger. Because of me and him, we laying on the block, rolling one up, smoking or drinking, whatever. And you know, no matter where that's at, it could be, like I said, in Brooklyn, it could be in Compton, it could be in the Vallejo. You know what I mean? It could be in Seattle, it could be in the south side of Chicago, or it could be in the full, you know, down in Texas, wherever it may be. And if we kicking it, be like, damn, man, you know what? Let's go rob some motherfuckers. We like this. That's why I say pull the trigger. When you tell a motherfucker go rob somebody, go shoot somebody, we like this. So you gotta take that same ingenuity, the same creativity. That's just like a thing, this cat. We was two partners and we was dope fiends, right? We was putting that spike in our arm, whatever it is. We gonna get up every day and we gonna figure out some extraordinary ways to get that money so we can put that spike in our arm. So we can slam dunk every day in our arm, in our veins. So that creativity that we gonna have to rob something or steal something out of the store, you know, wherever we walk in it together. You see what I'm saying? He go in the store, he fall out all in the store like having a seizure. I get the stuff or something or whatever it may be. It's this ingenuity that you have that's extraordinary. This creativity. Me and him in the penitentiary at the same time, same, you know, doing bits. Now, when you in that penitentiary and when you doing that, you're creative. Every move in there is based off survival. Every breath you take in the pen is based off survival. And we come up with these creative ways to eat, to make the food taste like mom cooked it. When the homie down the hall cooked it, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So it's this creativity we have. But when I say pull the trigger, I was talking to him like I was talking to anybody else, and I was saying, take that same ingenuity, take that same know-how and slam. Because think about this. You got dudes that's tough in the neighborhood, right? Motherfucker be tough in the neighborhood. Y'all ain't nothing in the other world security company. You see what I'm saying? You got cats that's good. I'm talking about, you got cats that's good with writing on walls and graffiti. Y'all ain't nothing but a marketing. You know, that's marketing. That's how I learned marketing, writing on walls. So that's art direction. It's marketing, it's graphic design, it's a lot of shit. So you gotta be able to take the things, you know what I mean? We gotta be able to take the stuff that we learned in the ghetto, that we learned based off survival and based off environment. See, everything is about environmental reaction. But sometimes we gotta reevaluate our whole approach. Environmental reaction is, if he do something to me, I'm going back and get a gun and I'm gonna slam on him. That's environmental reactions that we have. Now, if we live in Calabasas, and he do something to say something to me, I may say something back and walk away because it's an environmental reaction. Everything we know is based off the environments that we come from. Our environments educate us, educates us with how to react to things and how to deal with things. Now, it changed, you know, and sometimes people could change their environmental reaction if they move out and they be away for a while. But you know what I mean? That's just like when a kid come from the hood and he might go to school out in the suburbs, his reaction is different when somebody talking shit to him, he might punch him in the mouth. Now the principal calls his mom, well, you know, Gregory did this, like they was fucking with my kid, that's what we supposed to do. But they don't do that out there. They tell the teacher, oh, he's messing with me. So we gotta look at their whole game, but like this brother, he out here making it happen, and I'm just thankful that I'm part of your journey. And because somebody was a part of my journey. It was something that I read, it was something that an OG said to me in penitentiary. It was something that somebody told me when I was out there in the streets and I ain't paying attention to, that click later on, that was a part of my journey, that helped me. So it's like this. Motherfuckers ain't gonna never stop wearing clothes and all this. You said, I'm gonna take these clothes, I'm gonna slam it, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna create something that, you know what I mean, I'm gonna believe in it, and I'm gonna stand on that shit. Just like we're standing on robbing a nigga. Just like we're standing on the corner, that we don't own no property in the neighborhood. Only people that might own property is the elders, and we don't respect them like that. You know what I mean? And I ain't saying us. I'm talking about just the street mentality, just you, what you're doing in the environment of your community, and you fucking up the property value. You see what I'm saying? Because anytime somebody catch a case in that neighborhood, that shit like this. So you fucking somebody value up that been here forever before this dumb shit was going on, before you was born, and they worked hard to get the house, your grandma, your homie grandma, your homie mom. So, but at the end of the day, it's about, this shit is all about, man, pulling the trigger. Like, if you put the fucking gun down, if you ain't gonna pull the trigger. The gun is the idea, the gun is just that, it's just something. That's tell you to say, you know what, let me go hard.
And it's the truth, though. Like, really, I went to a barber shop. My boys that I had went down the street. My boys got a little clothing line that call them, I need all mine. And I went there and I got inspired, and I was telling them. I said, I'm inspired, man. I went home, came back, and was telling them, man, I'm really in here on Melrose. You know where we come from? Up here, you know, it's a whole different, this is like our dream. So anyway, and then after that, and then since seeing a post with you, pull the trigger, I came down here 2 days after that. And between that post, you can check the dates, all that right there. I even left a post. Like, I pulled the trigger, I'm on Melrose, because this type of stuff I'm feeding myself every morning. As soon as I roll out of bed, you know, it's the first thing I'm doing, feeding myself that good energy, you know, all my different little people. Then I go on and going about my day, because I'm a firm believer that, because I done been in situations where that's all you have was your creative imagination. And you know, after you do about 20 laps on the track or whatever, you at Venice Beach, you know how it is, when you in the zone, you somewhere else. You all the way, you know what I mean? And I seen that, pull the trigger, came down here and got this. And you know, I had to ride the slopes with Brand living up to his name. I ain't worried about that, because everybody that know me know that I'm kind of known for that little slogan, like ride the slopes, because that's the way it be.
Look at this, yo. Look at that logo. Take him inside. Come on. This is why you got to take him inside, right? All this started right here. All this started off of one Instagram post from a brother that don't even, two coaches didn't even know each other, but all this him. Right off of Melrose. Everything, all this stuff that everybody worship is right over there. He right there with all the stuff that people worship, all the brand, right off of Melrose.
What size you wear? Look at that.
Look at that.
What size you wear?
Look at that shit. Look at that patchwork.
What size you wear, Wallo?
I wear private.
Large.
You gonna figure it out.
Yeah,
man, this is where it's at, man. And you know what this is about, man? I'm gonna say this, and I'm gonna end mine. Final lap, the final lap, right?
And that's also numbers.
It's this thing that get inside of you. Everything that you ever did to the man, that shit come out of you. It's like a boxer. I mean, 12th round, man, the final lap.
Yeah, so it's a trip, that's where it started from. So it started with the final lap, and I basically like been saying that forever, and it really mean like that old lifestyle, everything I heard, man, I did all that. I done did it all, from the fizz to the stage to juvenile, to I already ran my final lap, I'm done. And what I was always doing was putting ride the slopes in the back, that was like my slogan, but I envisioned riding the slopes with his own logo, and make a long story short, that's the one that I really took off. And send me over here. Something I was just using for, you know how it be. It be something that you just writing on everything. It's a final lap, ride the slopes. That's what I'm saying. Like, that's what I'm at for Duke. But that was the one that sent me here though. But I'm highly grateful that my boys from Concrete sent them through. They had big work right now. And as soon as they slow down, I'm gonna be able to work with them, because I'm constantly in their ear.
They connect.
Telling me, big connectors. And good people, Concrete, so thank you.
That's why I'm here, because Concrete connected ex-cons that's out here doing things and pushing us and just building awareness about life ain't over, man, at the pit.
No.
It's just the beginning.
Really is.
You see what I'm saying? So that's what it's all about. Wallo 237, I'm signing off, man. The final lap, man, Ryan Slopes, right here, Melrose. Where you at? Why you playing games? Why you ain't out here copping? Stop bullshitting. It's just like that.
They run up on the nigga, tell him freeze now. My hands behind my back, I'm on my knees now. And I can hardly breathe now.
Take a walk with me, cause the world needs a resurrection, let it start with me. Wondering why I'm heartless is cause I chose to be. They will never by any means take my heart from me. Curiosity kills, out the window like Malcolm, waiting on what only heaven knows. I'll be here when it happens, when I mention parole. I can feel that reaction, calling for backup. What happens next, I can hardly imagine. Man. He told me to exit, his partner was laughing. Sir, I'm not resisting, listen, I just came from prison. My mama lived up the street.